Sarangani Province in Mindanao has been successful so far in preventing the entry of the coronavirus within its territory. The entire province used to be under an enhanced community quarantine, but this has been downgraded recently to a general community quarantine. It also has several isolation facilities for suspected COVID-19 cases. Sarangani Governor Steve Solon joins us now on the line. Governor Steve, magandang hapon po sa inyo.
Hi, Tony. Good afternoon. Mm-hmm.
So, how do you feel now that the entire province is under a GCQ, finally?
Yes, no, we're very happy. We're being blessed by God having zero COVID. And you know what, Tony? All the mayors in Sarangani and the province, they're really highly motivated, you know, to ensure that we protect our zero COVID status. Mm-hmm.
How did you do it? I mean, could you tell us why, in your view, you know, your constituents have avoided being infected by the virus?
Like I said earlier, Tony, it's important that to communicate properly. You know, so at the very beginning, we did not hide the truth from the people. In other words, we said, you know, this is a deadly disease. We cannot belittle it. So, you know, in short of saying that, we made the people vigilant. You know, so people now are, you know, willing to stay home. When they go out, they're wearing their masks. So I think it starts from here. And you know, like I said, Tony, Sarangani is being blessed because we are a tourism hub. No, so having zero COVID is really a miracle. Mm.
And right now, how are your constituents, you know, living the new normal in Sarangani under a GCQ?
You know what? It's key, Tony, that changing behavior is very difficult. So right now we are still pushing. We are our information campaign with the PNP and the AFP. They are going up to the mountains and they are advocating on you know, the minimum health standards. So, you know, day by day we keep pounding to the public that, you know, we have to distance ourselves from each other. We have to wear face masks. We have to wear. We have to wash our hands. So, Tony, it's important that we stress the gravity of the situation. We cannot belittle it, so the people themselves will protect themselves and their neighbors. Mm.
What kind of, you know, industries or even jobs have been reopened now in Sarangani?
Yeah, no, so the agriculture is moving. Our fishing industry is open, and aquaculture, so the big companies providing prawns, providing bangus and things of this nature, they're all open. And, you know, the private sector has been such a big part in our campaign. You know, they gave us PPEs, they're giving us food. So big companies with a lot of employees, they're requiring them to wear their masks, they're requiring them to get medical checkups. No, so whole community approach to fighting COVID dito sa Sarangani. Mm-hmm.
Right now, if you know, if you're going to talk about restrictions, you know, in movement of people under a GCQ, are there, you know, bordering provinces that are still being allowed to enter Sarangani?
Yes, even during an ECQ. We stop the movement of people because they are the carriers. No, but the cargo in and out, they are allowed to come in as long as they have the proper documentation, because we are boundaried by South Cotabato, Davao, Sultan Pudarat provinces. No, so and Gensan. So we need to tighten our border control. So hopefully this will continue until the COVID crisis ends.
And so, are there still people who may have been trapped in Sarangani during the lockdown, who will now be allowed to actually leave for those neighboring provinces?
Yes, as a matter of fact, those trapped in the borders, we have a ruling that they can go home, but the receiving LGU must pick them up at the checkpoint. In other words, you know, they cannot just say, "I'm going home." They have to wait at the border, show them their certificate of 14-day quarantine, and then the LGU or the mayor will go to the border and pick them up and take them straight home.
Yeah. What has been the economic impact for your province during the ECQ, and how do you make up for that during a GCQ?
You know, right now, I'm not saying it's farthest on our list, right? But we're really putting the health of the people first. Now, with a GCQ, you have labor-intensive industries opening. Like I said, you have agri, you have fisheries, plus construction is starting again. And Tony, our roads being built, going up to the mountains, we are requiring construction companies to employ 70% of the population from the community. You know? So this is going to generate cash flow in the hinterlands.
So you're looking at, you know, starting or restarting your industries in construction, and of course, as you said, in agriculture, aquaculture. Does this somehow help also restore the livelihood opportunities for people who may have been displaced during the ECQ?
Yes, absolutely. And you know, under GCQ, if you don't have a job in an essential industry like food, for instance, you cannot leave your house. So, you know, this is motivating some of those able people who didn't have a job even before COVID to come out and, you know, contribute and be more productive, no, to find a job in a essential industry.
Okay. You know, the issue of testing is still very much on top of the minds of the public, given that the government recently admitted that it hasn't met the target number of tests that it would have wanted by the end of April. How is testing going along or coming along in Sarangani? Did you set a target yourself for the province?
Yeah, you know, we've been trying to get a testing center for the region. Right now, there's only one testing center, which is in Davao. No? So you imagine how many provinces are sending their tests over there. So it's overburdened. So the way we're doing it in Sarangani, since the testing is still not at a level where it should be, we are really emphasizing wearing your mask, staying at home, and distancing. Because that's our only weapon at the moment. No, until we get all this testing ramped up, our only offensive right now is really the mask, the distancing, and the new behavior in terms of cleanliness.
And we've also talked, you know, recently about the hardships that the frontline workers have been going through. Some of them experiencing discrimination because they work in hospitals and treat COVID-19 patients. Did Sarangani ever see that happen during this time under an ECQ?
You know, we treat our frontliners here like gold, right? But I don't doubt, you know, people are people, right? If someone is near someone with an infectious disease, I think it's normal human nature to be afraid. But in Sarangani, even during the ECQ, I am on a daily basis with the frontliners. They have PPEs, we've given them masks, we've given some of them even goggles. So, you know, we are really equipping them, no? So at least they're protected when they're contact tracing or when they're facing people in the hospital.
All right. Governor Steve, my colleague Nikki De Guzman has some questions for you.
Hi, Nikki. Thank you.
Hi, Governor. Under the GCQ, mass gatherings still aren't allowed, but school classes are, especially for higher institutions, right? How does this work for Sarangani?
Well, in Sarangani, we really said no mass gatherings, so period, right? So currently in Sarangani, any mass gathering that's not of an essential nature or not under the GCQ type 1 industries, you cannot really congregate. So we're not having that problem in Sarangani at the moment.
So as for the schools, they would mostly be held online should classes start?
You know, a lot of our higher levels of education, like college, they're in Gen San. We have a few small colleges in Sarangani, but they are not operating at the moment.
All right.
All right, Governor Steve Solon of Sarangani, your province certainly would be a good, you know, example for other areas to follow in the Philippines once they actually emerge from an ECQ, and hopefully all of us will be off or out of lockdown maybe in a few months' time. Thank you very much for speaking
with
us.
Thank you very much.